In this tutorial series, we're going to be discussing how to implement a version of the Posner task. Before we get into the details of this particular example, though, we should first become familiar with the Experiment Builder user interface. On the right side of the interface is the Graph Editor window. This is where you drag experimental components to build a flowchart of your experiment. Above the Graph Editor window is the Experiment Component Toolbox. This component toolbox is divided into three sections: Action, Trigger, and Other. Each section contains several different components or nodes that can be added to the Graph Editor window to create the experimental flow and implement the intended experimental design. The nodes in the Action section perform some kind of action when they are encountered in the experimental flow. For example, the Display Screen action can be used to present stimuli to the participant Display PC monitor. Other nodes allow you to perform drift checks, play audio, record audio, interact with other experimental devices, and more. You can use the arrows on the right and left sides of the component toolbox to access all the available nodes. The nodes in the Trigger section wait for a particular type of event to occur before allowing the experimental flow to proceed. For example, the keyboard trigger waits for input on a keyboard. The mouse trigger waits for a mouse click, and you can specify a triggering region for this click if needed. Importantly, if your paradigm has a gaze contingent aspect to it, there are also some eye-based triggers that will fire based on eye sample data or eye events. These eye-based triggers won't be used in the current example, but they function like other triggers, making many gaze contingent designs easy to implement. Nodes in the Other category don't connect to other nodes, but instead serve some special functions. The most commonly used node in this section is the Variable node. Variable nodes are used to store values, and their values can be accessed by other parts of the project. They can be used in a lot of different ways, but they're commonly used to keep track of behavioral measures like reaction times and accuracies. On the left side of the interface, there are several panels. The Overview panel allows you to quickly move around in the Graph Editor window. The Structure panel provides a hierarchical representation of the project that provides an alternative way to access the different components of the project. The Structure panel also contains a Devices tab. When you go to the Devices tab, you are presented with all the hardware settings of the project. To change the settings of a given piece of hardware, navigate to its subsection and edit the properties below. The Properties panel shows the properties of whatever aspect of the project is currently selected. For example, if you click on a node to select it, its properties will be shown in the Properties panel. Properties that are not grayed out can be edited through the Properties panel. Finally, the Notes panel allows you to add notes for each node, for record keeping or instructional purposes. A critical aspect of any Experiment Builder project is its data source. These blue rectangles in the Graph Editor of an Experiment Builder project are special action nodes called sequences. Sequences allow you to repeat the same basic structure multiple times in an experiment, and can be used to implement repeating block or trial structures. To allow you to change the way the nodes of that sequence behave across its iterations, you can associate a data source with that sequence. A data source allows you to specify information that may need to change from trial to trial, like stimulus file names or locations. Typically, the trial level sequence of a project will have a data source associated with it, and you can access that data source by clicking on the data source property of the sequence or by selecting that data source from this drop-down menu at the top if a data source has already been created for that sequence. A data source allows you to define how aspects of that repeating sequence may change across iterations of the sequence. Each row contains information for a separate iteration of the sequence, or trial in this case, and each column contains a piece of information that needs to change from iteration to iteration, or trial to trial. Once a data source has been set up, you can use that information by making references to those data source columns from the properties of nodes and screen resources in the sequence. These references allow you to use the same basic skeleton structure of nodes for all the trials of your experiment, while ensuring that critical aspects of those nodes change from trial to trial. Using this fundamental experiment builder concept of making reference to data source columns allows you to present different stimuli across trials, change the locations of these stimuli on the screen, specify the correct response value for each trial, and much more. Moreover, Experiment Builder can randomize the order of the rows of the data source, allowing block and trial-based randomization schemes. We'll discuss these randomization options, as well as the details of how to make reference to data source columns in later videos in this series.